God bless you. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah to the Lord. Let's chase after the Lord together with our praise. Hallelujah. Let's chase after his heart with our worship. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, yeah. Saul says, I'm chasing after you. No matter what I have to do, I need you more and more. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm chasing after you. No matter what I have to do, I need you more and more. Come on, everybody, say I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing after you.
Tell the Lord, no matter what.
No matter what I have to do,
I need you. Come on, tell the Lord, I need you. way through.
I'm praising my way through.
Just to be closer.
Just to be closer to you.
I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing
only after you. I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing after you.
I'm praising my way through. Praise, Lord. We want our praise to get your attention, Lord. Anybody want your praise to get the Lord's attention? Does your praise get the Lord's attention this morning? Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Lord. We give ourselves to you, Lord. Totally, Lord. Totally yours, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. You can have our hearts, Lord. We belong to you, Father. We give you our desires, Lord, that you may give us your desire for our lives, Lord. Lord, let your kingdom come. Your will be done in us, Father. We bless you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, Lord. Let's sing it together. Here I am.
Here I am.
Here I stand.
Here I stand.
Lord, my life is in your hands.
Lord, my life is in your hands.
Lord, I'm longing to see.
Lord, I'm longing to see.
Your desire revealed it.
Your desire revealed in
me. I give myself away. Somebody open up your heart to the Lord. Sing it to the Lord. I give myself away. Sing it to Him. So you can use me. I give myself away. Heart, Lord,
take my heart,
take my life,
take my life
as a living sacrifice.
As a living sacrifice.
All my dreams, Lord,
all my dreams,
all my plans,
all my
Lord, I place them in your hands.
Give myself away.
Oh, Somebody lift it up to the Lord. All to thee.
All to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all.
Can we lift it up one more time to the Lord?
Lord, I surrender all.
You can have it all, Lord.
I surrender all to be my blessed Savior.
Thank you, Lord. And now it's time for prayer from Darius Williams.
Dear God, thank you for waking us up this morning. Continue to bless us, oh Lord, please. Heal the sick. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now can we all stand and sing hymn, turn to page 540, lift every voice and sing, amen.
Let every sound cloud as the flow.
Hallelujah. Now we may pause to have reflection of our Black History Month, given by Jamila Williams and Miss Taylor Foster.
Alva Ailey was an African-American choreographer and activist who founded the Alva Ailey Dance Company Theater in New York.
He was one of the greatest American choreographers. His talent went past his own ventures into creating widely acclaimed dance centers, theaters, and assemblies.
Alva Ailey was born on January 5th, 1931.
And he died December 1st, 1989.
Amen. Now we will present to you a dance.
Amen.
No man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtaposition in us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walk through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won,
woman and child.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Now it's time for our missionary offering, and Elijah Kalu will be standing for the offering.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Today's scripture will be from 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7, and it reads, "Every man according as his purpose and his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver."
Amen.
Thank you.
know I've been changed. I know I've been changed. But Lord, I know I've been changed. You know the angels in heaven done signed my name. Everybody say, I
know I've been changed.
Oh Lord,
I know I've been changed.
Good Lord,
I know I've been changed.
You know
the angels in heaven done.
Thank you so much, Minister Lee. God bless you. Elder Cleveland got that one together, didn't he? My, my. Yeah, yeah. Thank you, my brother. God bless you. Today is a wonderful day for us to be here today. Look what the weather was yesterday. Look what it is today. Wonderful, isn't it? Amen. And so we are going to thank God for what he does, for this is his world. We are his creatures. He is the creator of everything. He does what he does, and what he does is always best. So we just have to thank him for giving us a little more time here on this earth. So Paramount, I'm glad to see you. Glad to know that God continues to be in your life, and God continues to be in the life of this His church. No Bible study on Tuesday night. Pass the word along to those who normally attend Bible Institute that there will not be any on Tuesday night at 6:30. But remember that next Sunday, after the 11 o'clock hour, the credit union has open house. For those of you who are not members of your credit union, for this is the Paramount Baptist Church Federal Credit Union, you need to become a member of the credit union. You need to be saving, so that when you run short, you don't have to run to the church. And when you run to the church, somebody is going to ask you, are you a member of the credit union? And there are those of you who want to borrow money from the credit union, but you're not members. It doesn't work like that. You have to be a member. You got to be saving. For the credit union is governed by federal laws. And every year they audit the credit union. And if we are not in compliance, then we are in big trouble. Thank God that has not happened over the years, but every year they continue to give us a good mark. So we thank God for those who volunteer, Sister Harvey, Sister Taylor, Sister Pinckney, Brother John, and I don't know, Lisa Harris, and others, and who. You know, I always get myself in trouble, call some names, and then I forget other names. Any other name I've forgotten? All right, then. God bless you. Thank you, thank you. My memory is still good. I have to thank God for that. Oh, yes, oh, yes. But next Sunday is the credit union. Do not forget. In the bulletin this morning on page three, you see something about diamonds in the rough. You see where they're having a conference and the registration fee is there. You have to pre-register by the 12th. And the final day, the day of the conference is the 25th. Do I have it right, Dr. Shannon? I have it right? All right then. So keep these important days in mind, parents and guardians. Your young ladies, we thank God that we have someone, individuals, who can take the time to minister to our young ladies. So we thank God for that. So keep this important date in mind. Keep it in mind. Please do not forget. Remember the sick of our church, Sister Linda Williams, Sister Laura Stokes, there. They have an aunt who died recently, and Sister Stokes had an accident in her home and was hospitalized, but she's now home recuperating. Keep her in your prayers. Keep Deaconess Bennett and any other sick member in your prayers. Brother Alton Butler, keep him in your prayers. Keep him in your prayers. All right. God bless Brother Herbert Thomas and all the members, the Smiths, Trustee and Deaconess Smith. Keep them all in your prayers. They love their church, and if it were possible, they would be here in their church today. Well, keep them. Let them know that we are still praying for them, and we look forward to the day when they can return. God bless and keep you. God bless and keep you. At this time, someone from the youth ministry will come and greet all of us. All right, someone coming?
This is who's that? Deion Johnson.
Deanna Johnson?
Devin.
Or Devin? Oh, Devin. Okay, come Devin on. Johnson. Minister Lee, you can't read like me. All right, Devin. All right. Oh, Lord. That's quite a difference from Deanna to Devin. I'm going to rub it in.
Good morning,
go ahead, my dear. Good morning.
I'd like to welcome all the guests that are here today. For your guests, please stand.
All right. Are there any visitors with us? Any visitors? Right in front of me? Oh, yeah. Don't sit down yet. Don't sit down yet. Don't sit down yet.
We want to welcome you on behalf of the youth in Paramount to 11 o'clock service. We also have 9 o'clock Bible study and 7 o'clock a service back in the hands of our pastor.
Thank you, young Miss Johnson. Thank you so much. Amen. Can you tell us who you are and who invited you to be with us today? Way, way out there. Ooh. All right. Who invited you? Oh, Sister Shirley, Deaconess in Training, Strowman and Deacon in Training, Mitchell. Oh, yeah. God bless you. God bless you. Yeah, they got you all the way from the West Coast. Amen. We are happy to have you. Enjoy the worship today. Please enjoy it. And take the blessings of Christ Jesus back to your place of abode and to your worship center. Those of you who are close by to this or a guest, shake your hand warmly. And the rest of us, let us acknowledge your presence. All right. God bless, God bless. Let us stand now and move around and greet someone. Let us stand now, move around and greet somebody. Greet somebody. Thank you. Wonderful, wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Do not forget that next Sunday we wear our African attire. Don't forget, don't forget. If there are children up here who need to be in children's church, need to go downstairs, need to be downstairs to be in children's church. If there are children up here, need to be downstairs, children's church. Do not forget the Body and Soul workshop. Do not forget how to handle your grief, how to handle your grief. Do not forget it. God bless and keep you. I turn it back in the hands of the worship leader.
Praise the Lord. I must say my pastor got it right. I can't see. Hallelujah. Amen. Then it's time for us to have Ministry of Music by our junior choir and PYP.
Thank you. every time I feel a spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel a spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the spirit moving in my heart, I will pray.
On the mountain, my God spoke.
Find me when I'm lost. your blood was red. We may be different, but the God we serve's the same. Yeah, every Sunday we separate and bring the Father pain. Your name is higher than any other, yet you took my place instead. And now my sins are washed away because your blood was red. For it's strong enough to wash away my sins. Pure enough to cleanse me deep within. Real enough to find me when
generations bled for our deserved equality. Red, the color that presently bleeds on these streets for justice daily. In the words of Isaiah 54:17, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Amen. And we shall rise as we always have. Is red still just a color to you?
Water, way in the water. gonna trouble the water. God's gonna trouble the water.
It's wonderful to be young, isn't it? And to have those tender children's voices and then our youth choir. We thank God for the training that they are receiving. Amen. We come now, Christian friends, to worship God by paying our tithes and giving offering. Every member, every guest, or to have something to give. Elijah, when he came forward for the missionary offering, says, upon the first day of the week, everyone needs to have something, and that we are not to give grudgingly or stingily or to be cheap in our giving. Let's not do that in God's house. But let us come with a generous heart. Let us come with a liberal spirit. And give God what is rightfully his. He says, the tithe is mine, it is holy. Will you now be obedient to God's word and come? Bow your heads with me now. Thank you, God, for these your people. They are here to worship you now with their gifts. Use these gifts and use them, we beseech thee. So that through them and their gifts, the gospel of Christ may be proclaimed everywhere. Bless this your church as it is the steward of these gifts. May your church use them to benefit the gospel and humanity. In Jesus' name we pray. And the people of God say together,
the ministerial staff, ushers, please bring your tithes and offering. Everyone to my right and left and far corners, following the directions of the ushers, bring your tithes and offering. Follow directions of the ushers, bring your tithes and offering. Choir, you can come at this time. Thank you.
Now it's time for our meditation hour. And our meditation will be led by Little M. Bell. Our song will be page 375, I Must Tell Jesus.
Come to the altar. Jesus has promised that if you did by faith come to the altar, he will meet you there. And just keep in mind that his arms is not too short. He can reach you anywhere that you are. Our hymn is I Must Tell Jesus.
Burdens alone.
For he is able
in my distress, he kindly will help
me.
He ever loves and cares for his own. I must tell Jesus. I must tell Jesus, I cannot bear my burdens alone. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, Jesus can help me. Us alone.
Let us look to the hills. And that scripture means look beyond the hills. Look to the one who made the hills. The psalmist say, I will look towards the hills from which cometh my help. He said, now I've learned and I know that my help, all of my help, hallelujah, comes from the Lord. The Lord that made heaven and earth. The Lord that said in the beginning, I am. Father, we come to you at this hour. And we come in the precious, holy, divine name of Jesus. The name that is above all names. The name that every knee will bow. Every tongue will confess that he's Lord. In that name that only can save. Thank you right now, Father, for the privilege to come before the true and living God. Just for a moment, Lord, if we just look back and look at the deep seas and everything that's in it. Hey, my Father, we know there is a God. Lord, if we just look at the firmament that declares your glory, we know there's a God. When we look back and see how far you have brought us, we know that there is a God. And you said, I am he. And Father, we thank you today for your precious, darling son, Jesus. You have told us in your word that we can come boldly before the throne of grace that we may find mercy and help and grace to help in the time of need. And God, your people have come before you. They'll come saying, Father, in the name of your son, Jesus, I need you. They come saying, it's me, O Lord. Right now, God, it's not my sister, it's not my brother, but it's me, oh Lord. I'm standing, Lord, in the need of prayer.
I need you, Lord. I can't do nothing without you, God. Your people has come before you. And you told us that we can come and let our requests be made known unto God. That's why we come saying, I must tell Jesus. Tell him all about my trials. I cannot bear them. And I hear God saying, you've come to the right place. That I am God. And beside me, there is none other. If you would give yourself to me, I will just answer your prayer. I will take care of every need that you have. I will supply every need according to my riches and glory by my son Jesus. Father, we thank you now that we have come to let our requests be known unto God. So each and every one of you just talk to your Father. In the name of your Savior, Jesus Christ. It's good to tell your friends, but now we must tell Jesus. Tell him all about it. Don't leave anything out. Tell him all the good about it and tell him all the bad about it and leave it with him. Tell him all about it. Thank you, Lord. Now pray for someone else. Tell God that your sister and your brother is going through right now. And God, I just stand with them. I don't know anything else to do, God, but stand with them in the name of your son. Realizing that he's able to do what is needed. Pray for your church. That God would strengthen our church. That he would use our church for his purpose. Whatever the purpose is. That we stand together as one body in Christ. Right here at Paramount. Thank him how he has brought you through. Thank him that the storm was raging, but it didn't affect you. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, that he spread his wings all over you and nothing could touch you. Thank him that no weapon formed against you will prosper. It may have been formed, but it couldn't go anywhere. Thank him that the blood is on your doorpost. And anything that's not of him must pass over in the name of Jesus. Pray for your pastor. That the God will strengthen him in every way that he needed. That he knows every, God, you know everything. And not only do you know everything, but with you nothing shall be impossible. Let God know that we are just reminding him of his word. He said, keep me in remembrance of my word. You say, if we follow after you, that we will never walk in darkness. Thank him how he provided. That the mortgage is paid. There's food on the table. Thank you, Lord. For all you've done. Thank you for our salvation. Thank you for Jesus who died. Thank you for the Holy Spirit indwelling within us. Thank him for the Trinity. Thank him that in you, Lord, I have everything I need. I'm not missing a thing in you. I just need to walk your way and do your will, and it is done. Every need is met. And wherever I left the dot off, God, you'll go in there and dot it. Because you're a forgiver of sin. Thank you, Lord. Have your way in my life. And Lord, if I'm at a point where I don't understand what I'm saying, help me to say it with strength, Lord, that I mean it from my heart. Help me. Thank you, Lord. Bless our government. Your word said the government would be upon the shoulder of your son, Jesus. So now, Lord, the government is on the church. If the church don't pray, the government can't make it. Hallelujah, Lord. Oh, God, I thank you. I thank you, Lord, that if the church prays for the government, things will begin to fall in order. Because you hear and answer the prayer of the righteous. And we are the righteous through the blood of Jesus Christ. So we come in joy. We come in praise and worship unto you. Knowing that you hear and answers prayer. And we thank you, Father. We praise and we worship your holy name. In Jesus' name that we pray. Let the church say amen. Amen. And amen. Amen.
I must tell Jesus.
Yes.
I must tell Jesus. I cannot bear these burdens alone. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, Jesus can help
me,
Jesus alone.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Now we come a time in our time for scripture will be found in Numbers 12, 1 through 2, and it will be led by Ricky Bowie.
Thank you. Okay. Like she said, scripture.
May we all stand, please.
And Miriam and Aaron spake against Moses because of the Ethiopian woman that he had married. For he had married an Ethiopian woman. And they said, hath the Lord indeed spoken only by Moses? Hath he not spoken also by us? And the Lord heard it.
Amen. 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 Hallelujah. It's next. It's time for the ministry of music, followed by our Yates Choir. But before we get to the Yates Choir, we're going to look at our pastor because he's going to bring the next word. And we're going to say, preach, pastor. Preach, pastor, and preach. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody give the Lord glory. Come on, if that's why you came today, just give him glory. Say hallelujah to the Lord. He's worthy of all the glory. Don't we serve such a wonderful God? There's no one like our God. He's faithful in all of his ways. He's a God in whom we can come to no matter where we are in life, no matter what our problem, what our situation is, and we can lay our burdens down at his feet. What a wonderful God we serve. And he's more than deserving of all of the glory and all of our praise. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, yeah. We worship you, Jesus. We give you glory. because you deserve it. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. Did you come to give up glory this morning? Lord, my hallelujah belongs to you. Oh, yeah, yeah. My hallelujah belongs to you. And this is why, Lord, you deserve it. You deserve it. Yeah. You deserve it. You deserve it. Everybody say, my hallelujah belongs to you.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on, sing it to the Lord this morning. Say, my hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on, if you know he deserves your praise, say, my hallelujah.
My hallelujah
belongs
to you.
Yeah, Lord. My hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Now tell them why it belongs to them. Somebody open up your mouth and say, you deserve it.
You deserve it.
What you deserve.
You deserve it.
All of the glory belongs to you, Jesus.
You deserve it.
All of my praise.
You deserve it.
Say, all of the glory.
All of the glory belongs to you.
All of the glory, yeah.
All of the glory
belongs
to you.
So we lift up the glory to you, Jesus. All of the glory,
all of the glory belongs to you.
We come to give you glory. We come to give you glory, Jesus.
All of the glory,
yeah,
belongs,
yeah,
to,
yeah,
you.
Yeah.
You deserve it.
You deserve it.
You deserve it.
We exalt you, Lord, because
you deserve it.
We magnify your name because
you deserve it.
You deserve it.
You deserve it.
So we give it to you, Lord.
You deserve it.
We give you all of our worship, Lord.
You deserve it.
You deserve it.
You
thank you. No, he deserves the praise. Oh, Lord, we give you glory, Jesus. You're worthy of it, Father. It belongs to you, Lord. We withhold no praise from you, Lord. But we give you our hearts, Lord. We give you our minds, Lord. We lift it up to you, Jesus. Oh, yeah, yeah. Give you glory. Can we lift it up one more time? Say hallelujah.
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 All the glory.
All the glory.
All the honor.
All the honor.
All the praise.
All the praise. You deserve it.
You deserve it.
You deserve it.
My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on, tell the Lord is here. Say, my hallelujah belongs.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Oh, my hallelujah. Say,
my hallelujah belongs to you.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
He deserves our honor. He deserves our praise. He deserves our hallelujah. So hear us now, O God. Hear us. Be with us, O God, in this moment. Strengthen us, we beseech thee. Open ears and hearts, O God, we pray. Turn someone around towards you. In Jesus' name, amen. Brother Donald, you still here? Donald? Still here? All right, over there. Three Sundays straight, Donald. All right, you have to keep it up, man. You have to keep it up. You want to keep it up? Amen. Keep it up. You make a promise. You made a promise. Amen. Made a promise. Keep it up. Good to see you. Amen. You normally sit around the back, so that's where I was looking for him. I didn't know it was all up here. Amen. Around 6:30 last evening, Minister Jones called to tell me that Reverend Dunmore, who was supposed to preach, brother, turn it up a little, that Reverend Dunmore, who was supposed to preach at this hour, that she was down with a high temperature and in bed. That he tried to reach Reverend Bell, but was not successful. I'll leave it at that. And so I have to do what I tell my young preachers. You always, whether you're up to preach or not, you must always have a sermon ready. Have one in your head, one in your heart, and one written down. You don't know when you'll be called upon suddenly. So I have to. Live out what I preach. Isn't that right? So I come to you this morning, my brothers and my sisters, with this sermon subject, when trouble comes from where you least expect it. Did you hear what I say? When trouble comes from where you least expect it. Has that ever happened to you? On the job, you are friends with a colleague, your cubicle is next right to there. And then all of a sudden, you go to work one morning. You didn't do anybody anything, but all of a sudden, the atmosphere has changed. Faces frowning. Don't talk to you. You wonder, what have I done? I did not. Trouble can come from where you least expect it. Trouble can come from any situation. And it does not mean that it's because you are so unholy. For even holy folk in church every Sunday, folk, Bible study prior service, even they experience incidences where things crop up. We are the least expected. And when they come, you just have to know that you have to have God with you. A group of people known as the children of Israel, they had received their emancipation proclamation from Pharaoh. They were told to leave, and there it is on their march. On the march to the promised land, they came up across a river. They came up on mountains on either side. And behind them, Pharaoh chasing them. You see, Pharaoh set them free. But it seemed as if his heart was not in the freedom proclamation that he gave them. For he was losing all that free labor. He was losing all of the economic well-being that the Hebrew slaves provided Egypt. So reluctantly, Pharaoh said, get out of here. And so after so many years, the children of Israel left Egypt. Along with, the Bible says, with a mixed group. With a multitude of mixed group. Perhaps those who had intermarried, they left. Well, then trouble came, as I said. My brothers and my sisters, do not believe that the pharaohs of this world want to set you free. The pharaohs of this world know the benefits that they can get out of you. So they do not want to give you freedom. The pharaohs of this world that bind you, one of them perhaps is the bottle that binds you, don't want you to be free, wants you to be dependent on that bottle. The pharaohs of this world don't want you to be free from gambling. They want you to, the pharaohs of this world want you to continue gambling. They don't want you to say, I've beaten the habit. The overeating habit that some of us have, and we want to get a reduced diet and take exercise. The pharaohs of this world don't want you to have that. The pharaohs of this world will talk to you and say you're going to damage your health. The pharaohs of this world, my sisters and my brothers, do not want to release you, for they know what they have in you. And so Pharaoh got in hot pursuit of the children of Israel. In fact, when they had not reached the promised land, he thought that they were lost in the wilderness. But God has a way of providing shelter for his people, does he not? God has a way of looking out for his people. And so when they came to the Red Sea, God parted the Red Sea for the children of Israel. And Pharaoh with his mighty army drowned. My sisters and my brothers, as they were on their journey, here they came across where they were to cross over, and the Philistine army, the Philistine strong, powerful army in the way. There will be some strong folk in your way when you want to do right. There will be those who are stronger than you, who don't want you to progress. There are those, my brothers and my sisters, who will tell you that the journey is taking too long. That those who don't want you to have any vision at all. They as long as you can stay right where you are, it suits them. But don't try to make any progress in life at all. Don't try to better yourself at all. The enemy will try to retard your progress. The enemy will be right there. Do not feel that you are so strong. Enemy is right there, ready to come after you. The children of Israel were not strong enough to fight the Philistine army. They were not strong. And so they just had to go around. Now, if they had not gone around, they could have gone right through the Philistine territory. And they would reach the promised land within a matter of days. But they had to go all the way around. It took them a long time. And in addition, as they were going to the promised land, they came across the Amalekites. Amalekites, ancient enemies of Israel, fought them. Yes, they did. My brothers and my sisters, as you're on your Christian march towards glory, there will be those who are going to fight you. There will be those who are going to stand in the way. There will be those who will try to beat you down and prevent you every step of the way. And even somebody who knows the Lord will try to lead you astray. Did not Aaron try to lead the children of Israel astray when Moses had gone up to Mount Sinai? Thought that Moses took too long, and so they built a golden calf and began to celebrate, began to shout. They said, Moses has taken too long. And there were those who said, let's get back to Egypt. For in Egypt we were eating better. We were doing much better there. On your journey there will be those naysayers. There will be those who have no vision. On your journey there will be those who are complaining. There will be those who are doubters. There will be those who are telling you that building the church has taken just too long. But if the Lord has given you a vision, you better stay with it. If the Lord has told you what to do, you better stay with that vision. My brothers and my sisters, there will be impediment in the way. According to our scripture for this morning, it says, for Moses encountered trouble from where he least expected it. This text tells us that his brother Aaron and his sister began to complain against Moses. Did you remember what Ricky read? Ricky said that Aaron and Miriam began to complain. Began to say, are there not more prophets other than Moses? Does God only talk to Moses? What about us? We have known the Lord a long time. We have been serving him a long time. What about us? Has God forgotten me? Now Moses did not expect trouble to come from his blood brother and his blood sister. Trouble can come from where you least expect it. Even in the home, trouble can come.
Your own children can rise up against you. Mother and father may not agree about something. Trouble can come from where you least expect it. Here, trouble, according to the text, trouble come from Aaron. Now, Aaron is Moses' brother. Remember Aaron? Moses, when told by God to go down to Egypt and tell Pharaoh, let my people go, Moses began to make excuse. Moses said, look, God, my speech. So God said, look, Aaron, I had the problems. Look, Moses, I had the problem solved. Your brother is very fluent. His speech is good. He does not have any stammering about him. Take your brother, and he will talk to Aaron down there in Pharaoh. So here it is, Moses' own brother. Has that ever happened to you? Family problems, has that ever happened to you? His own brother, Dr. Aaron, Bishop Aaron, Apostle Aaron, Pastor, President of the Convention, began to dispute with Moses. Then not only that, his sister began to talk to him. Now, Miriam is the one, after they crossed the Red Sea, Miriam is the one who got the tambourine and who got those ladies, and they began to shout and began to praise God, began to talk, tell God thanks how you brought us over. And here, tambourine beating Miriam. Here, prophetess Miriam. Here, praying Miriam. Here, Holy Ghost filled Miriam. Fire baptized Miriam. Came up against his brother. Don't be too secure, my brothers and my sisters, for even right there, trouble can come from where you least expect it, from your own family. But look what they were fussing about. Look what they were complaining about. They were complaining against Moses' African wife. Did you hear what I said? Black African American Sunday, you hear what I say? Does not the Bible say that Moses' wife was from Africa? Where is Ethiopia? His wife was from Ethiopia, the south of Egypt, in the sub-Sahara region down there. From Africa. Yeah, the wife was from Africa. They were complaining against Moses' African wife. But you know what? Sometimes when folk are fussing over something, it's not what they are fussing over. They are fussing about something, but not what you think they are fussing about. Moses' wife was just an excuse. They were up to a power play. Aaron from the start wanted to be in charge. That's why when Moses was up there talking to God and Sinai, he led the people astray. And Miriam wanted to be the only woman in Moses' life. She didn't want another woman in Moses' life. She who nursed Moses. She who, along with the mother, put Moses in the Nile River. Amen. And floated down the Nile River. Amen. And it rested at the feet of Pharaoh's daughter. Amen. That same Miriam was standing by and seeing everything. Amen. And volunteered to Pharaoh's daughter to look. I know somebody who can take care of that baby. And here it is with all. What all three of them had gone through. Here it is. They are fussing over the pigmentation of a woman. My brothers and my sisters, sometimes when folk around you are fussing about something, that's not what is on their heart. They have something else, another agenda. They're just hiding what's on their heart. But Moses did not get mad with them. He didn't cuss them out like how I would have done. He did not say, I'm going to get rid of my wife. He did not become defensive. In fact, the Bible says, maybe in verse 3 of that very same chapter, chapter 12 of Numbers, that Moses was the most humble person in all of the earth. He did not get angry. But God got angry. God did something to Miriam. Right there in that very same passage, it says that Miriam's body became white as snow. She had leprosy. Don't mess with God's servant. Don't mess with God's man. God has a way of looking out for his servants. She had leprosy, she had leprosy, she had leprosy. Moses did not expect trouble to come from within his own family, but she had leprosy. God struck her with leprosy. Oh, look. When Aaron saw it, Aaron said, it doesn't look good. Look like a baby just come out of the womb. Aaron said, no, it doesn't look good at all. Moses, do something, Moses. And Moses prayed to God. Oh, my brothers and my sisters, God will hear the cry of those who have trouble. He will answer. Yes, he will, won't he? When you have trouble in your life, what did you do? Did you go to God and pray? Or did you try to get even? Moses teaches us that don't get even, just leave it to God. Just put it in God's hand, and God will take care of the situation. God said, the battle is not yours. It's mine. Just stand back and see what I will do. When trouble comes from where you least expect it, just put it in God's hand. Yeah. Leave it to God. And he will take good care of it. Yeah. I can see Judas now. Jesus had trouble. Yeah. Judas betrayed him. Did he not? I can see Peter now. Peter denied him. Jesus had trouble from where he least expected it. No, those out there, the publicans and the sinners, the scribes and the Pharisees, can cause me all kind of mess, but not my own disciples. Not the disciples that I spent 3 years with, not them, but trouble came right from within. Peter, who was speaking up for Jesus. Judas, who carried the money. Yeah, they turned on Jesus. One betrayed him and one denied it. But when Jesus died, when he hung there on Calvary, I hear Jesus saying, Father, oh Father, Father, oh Father,
Be merciful to them. Forgive them, for they know not what they do. My brothers and my sisters, when Satan comes in the form of somebody you know, just talk to God. Don't get even. Don't cuss them out. Just take it to God and give it to God. And God, won't God take care of it? Won't God take care of it? Has he ever done that for anyone here? Has he ever taken care of your trouble? Have you ever gone to him and pray to God and say, God, I'm having this. I can't handle it by myself. Just come by. Oh, be not dismayed. What here betide? God will take good care of you. Trouble gonna come. Trouble gonna come. Some mess gonna come. But when they come, call on God and he will hear. He said, I fight your battle. I fight your battle. I'm glad. He has fought some battles for me. I have some more battles down the road. And I'm going to call on him. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for fighting my battle. Thank you, Lord, for hearing my prayer. Thank you, Lord, for being there. Oh, yes. Yes. Anybody in trouble? Anybody in trouble? Anybody in trouble? The Pharaohs don't want to let you go. Enemies are in your way. They lie in you. Or even some that you trusted that they are strong in the Lord, they will lead you astray. But when all of that happens, just call on the Lord. Yeah, he's never far. He's never far. He's never far. God bless and keep you. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Trouble, you're in trouble. Come now, come. Give your life to the Lord. Give your life to the Lord. We are not going to ask you what trouble you're in. They can come, come. You're out of the ark of safety. Come on in, come on in. Give your heart to the Lord. Give your heart to the Lord.
I'll just say yes.
You've been baptized, but you're not active in the church.
Afraid,
just come and be a part of this congregation.
For me to say, this life you gave is not my own. I'm trusting you to hear my yes and lead me on. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I'll just say yes.
You lead the way.
I'm not afraid of what it means for me to say.
This life you gave
is not my own.
It's not my own.
Ooh, oh, I'm trusting you to hear my yes and lead me on. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
My life.
My life.
It's yours.
Yes, Lord, we belong to you. Our lives were yours, Lord. Get glory out of these lives. Let us live for you, God. Let us live for you. Let us live for you, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. My life is yours.
God bless you and keep you. God bless you and keep you. Remember from where the text came, from Numbers 12, read that chapter. Remember the announcement pertaining to our young ladies, diamonds in the rough. Remember. Next Sunday, remember, the open house, credit union. Do business at your own lending institution right here at Paramount. God bless and keep you. Next Sunday, wear your African apparel as we finish celebration of Black History Month here at our church. And we thank God for all those who have participated, the young ladies who dance, Alvin Ailes. There, we thank God for them, we thank God for them. And for others, Corey and others who have given us snippets of Black history, we thank God for that. Let us stand.
I got a testimony when I look back over my life. And I think things all over. I can truly say that I've been blessed. I got a testimony. Oh, when I look back over my life.
And I think things all right.
I can truly say
that I've been blessed.
I got a testimony.
May the Lord go with you. May the Lord keep you. May he sustain you. And may he stand by your side every step of the way. For it is to him that we give honor and glory, now henceforth, even forevermore.
Amen.